damage.
Do you like cartoons? You'll love entering my world of tunes. A world of pain. A world of absolute enjoyment. A world of devastating wackiness. A whole new tune world. Allow me to show you the newest page. Blue Eyes Tune Dragon. I'm a boy. Yuki boy. Yuki boy. Welcome to Tune World. In the Toon Kingdom, my monsters are immune from all of your effects. So I'll summon Toon Cannon Soldier, and I'll sacrifice this lovely monster to do some damage with it. And then...
It's down. That's also a lovely tomb. I mean, that has like
this lovely lady to summon the tune dark magician girl. I end my turn with that. Tune Goblin Attack Force. Okay, Tune Mermaid, I'll have to pay 500, but it's well worth it if I get to attack you directly.
I don't think so. Go, negate attack. Guess what, Pegasus? My trap that stopped you in your tracks, because negate attack actually negates your...
Oh, no. Kaiba boy, are you actually explaining what negate attack does?
Yeah, have you already seen the card? It can do anything. Maybe it could negate only 3 attacks. But no, it negates all of them. And then your battle phase is simply over.
Kaiba boy, you have a lot to learn about the business. And about the dangers of tunes. Attack whatever he's got face down there. I guess I can start looping the penguin soldier. Keep bouncing that Tune Dark Magician girl. But I've got this for a couple more turns. Alright.
Yo, Keelzar's front and center. Attack that monster.
Ooh, you've made me. Miss a damage. This is my lovely Tune Mask Sorcerer. Whenever he does damage, well, I get to draw one card. And since he's a Tune Monster, he can attack directly, Kaiba Boy. Since I have Tune Rope. Tune Dark Magician Girl, number 2. I end my turn with that.
All right. I've got a card for you, Pegasus, and it's one of my best flip cards. Now I'll flip summon Penguin Soldier. When this monster's flipped, well then, I can return up to 2 monsters to the hand. So I'll return Soldier itself, as well as your Tune Dark Magician Girl. Next, I'm going to summon a new monster. Go, Exarion Universe! Exarion, destroy the Tune Mermaid now.
Oh no.
All right, Pegasus, I think I'm done for now. I'll switch some of my monsters to defense. And I'll set another card face down. I'll end my turn. Ooh, tune table of contents. With this, I can add any tune card, and I think I'll take the lovely blue-eyes tune dragon. Now watch, Kaiba boy. It's not in my turn, and don't summon it at all. Now I'll show you a terrifying combo, Pegasus. I'm going to get rid of your Toon World. Ready? Go! Hurricane! This blows away all spells and traps. And now that you have a hand chock full of cards, go, Delinquent Duo! By giving up 1,000 of my life, I discard 2 random cards. Take it by the Blue Eyes Toon Dragon and Imperial and Ultimate Offering. Now then, I'll set 2 cards face down, Pegasus. And I'll end my turn with that. Defense mode, Ixarion. Go, I end my turn. I activate Toon World once again. This gives my toons the ultimate protection, because once they're in this page, their bindings can't be destroyed by any magic. Toon Gemini Elf. I'll simply attack you directly. I don't think so. Go, Ring of Destruction. I might as well take your monster down with me, Pegasus. And I'll destroy 2 Goblin Attack Force now. Alright. Now I sacrifice Toon Gemini Elf, summon my last Toon Doc Magician Girl. With that, I end my turn. A face down card. And then, Pegasus, I'm going to do something a little interesting. I'll flip one of my Momongas that you know is face down. Then, I'll attack your Toon Dark Magician Girl. What? Why would you do that to a monster's weaker? Simple, Pegasus. When Nimblemogus destroyed battle, I gained 1,000 life points. It's almost like my life points didn't change at all. However, one thing did change. Now I am able to set this monster. You know what's coming next. Might as well give up, Pegasus. Go, Toon Dark Magician Girl. Direct attack. I don't think so. I'll attack back the... I'll use Negate Attack, which I brought back with Mask of Darkness quite a while ago. Now, say goodbye to your toons, Pegasus, because I'm going to put them right where they belong. But first, go. Penguin Soldier. Let's... No! I didn't mean to do that. Whoops. I thought that was going to ask me to do Penguin Soldier's effect. I'm sorry, guys. I threw right there. No. Ah, well. I am my turn. I threw so hard right there. Oh, man, the button from. Oh, man. It got me. Sir. Anyway, that's not. Well, I guess I can read his line. Let's see.
You should know by now that I never make mistakes. My millennium eye. You had no chance, Flood.
All right. Let's go with... this deck here.
Thank you. The other one. I like you. As a friend, of course, my heart still belongs to Yugi. You let me register you as a duelist, right?
Sure, Rebecca, sure.
Yay! Now you're also friends with Teddy. Say hi, Teddy.
It's you. You are the winner of the Expert Cup. My Millennium Necklace has predicted you would win it. You're also the chosen one. Wait, what? Me? You sure Joey isn't the chosen one? Or, yeah, I don't know. I seem like the frozen one? I'm just kind of here. I have a question, not for your mind, but for your heart. My friend, what power do you desire?
And we get an option here. I think we'll say we desire power. So, yeah, power or unity. But we'll say we desire power.
Ah, just like I thought.
What do you mean, Ishizu?
However, another person already has that card.
What? The other person has the power card?
I got power. Electricity. I got power. I got power. Ooh. I got power. Ooh. Yes, but that person is also a chosen one.
Oh, Yami Yugi. Yeah, we know he's chosen. He's the king of games or something. King of Duels.
The two of you must duel in order to determine who truly deserves the card more.
Okay, I'll duel Yami Yugi, no problem. You know, he's the chosen one. Yami Yugi's probably the chosen one. Yeah, he's gotta be, right? He's got the Millennium Puzzle.
Besides, he's also the main character. How can the main character not be chosen and be the chosen one?
I was wondering why you called me out and ordered me a duel, Ishizu. I didn't know someone like you was worthy of having an Egyptian god.
Seto Kaiba's a chosen one? What's up, Kaiba?
Ah, you're the one who won the last tournament, the Expert Cup, Flooded Mod 14. Duel me here and now. In order to prove that I am truly the greatest duelist. And I will show you what power's about. For I have a new card since we last met, Flood. A card like no other. You may call it. That's right. I have an Egyptian god card.
Egyptian what?
I'll show you why I'm the chosen one. And you're just a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate deck. Now let's duel. Huh, I can't believe you have the guts to duel me with that pathetic duelist level. You'll never lay your hands on my Egyptian god card. It's time to duel.
Well, apparently our duelist level isn't very high. Blue eyes burst. All right, let's do it. And apparently Seto Kaiba's a chosen one. I would imagine Yami Yugi's got to be the third chosen one, though, right? Like, he's got to be. Gotta be. Anyway, pretty interesting story stuff going down right there. All right, here we go, guys. Here we go. Not bad. I draw. Jinzo Ningen, Psycho Shaka. Krita Shokan. Ideo. Iwa Skato Seto Kaiba. Tenendo. Omaido Tante.
Alright, I'll show you how to wield the power of a god. I activate Fusion Gate. With this, I'm able to call forth monsters if they fuse together, using the materials from my hand and banishing them. Now go, Gilosaurus, get out of here. I'll also summon the one and only Lashin, the mystical genie of the lamp. My wish is to control an Egyptian god card, and I have it. Thank you, Lashin, my wish is granted. Now, Obelisk will come to my hand. Everything's moving according to plan.
That may be, Kaiba, but my monster also has an effect. So, whenever my set gets destroyed in battle, I'm able to add a monster with 1,500 or less points to my hand. So, I think I'll add the one and only... Witch of the Mystic Tomato. Tomato. Go, Lushin. Destroy Flood's life points. Now. Oh no. His Shini got a direct hit. What else shall I do? This doesn't look good. I'll set one card face down, and I end my turn, Flood. Alright, Kaiba, I draw. Exit cannon. Good. Now I activate Luminous Spark. Not only does this knock out your field card, Kaiba, but... it also gives all light monsters 500 more points. Now I've got another combo for you. I activate Call of the Hunted. This will revive my Sengen right here and now. Kaiba, get ready. Now, I'll thoroughly destroy your defenses, Kaiba. Ready? I summon the one and only by tributing Sengen, Jindling and Psycho Shaka. I don't know what your face down is, Kaiba, but now you can't activate it. It's probably a trap. And with Sengen's other effect, I'll take Z Metal Tank into my hand. Alright, Kaiba, prepare to lose Lashin. Go, Jinzo.
Cyber Energy Shock. Looks like your trap cards are useless, Kaiba.
Shadow. Sinbone Zakura Kageyoshi. Alright.
But Jinzo on the field, I end my turn.
Pathetic Wheeler, I draw. I'll activate Pot of Greed. What does this card do? I don't know, but suddenly I have more cards in my hand. Now then, I'll end my turn with that.
Draw. I summon Mystic Tomato. Next. I'll attack whatever you have face down there, Kaiba. Go, Jindo Ningen, Shiko Shaka. Cyber Energy Shock. Go, my ripe tomato. Serve him a sandwich with extra lettuce and yourself. All right, I end my turn, Kaiba.
Fine. I draw minor setback. I summon this monster face down and I'll end my turn, but...
What's the matter, Kaiba? Jinzo too powerful for you?
No, not at all.
Well, fine. I summon Kanan Soldier. This monster's quite special. By tributing other monsters, I can do, damage for each of them. And now I'll equip my Kanan Soldier. With the mighty united we stand. So, the monster equipped with this monster gains points for every monster I have on the field, and I count three. Go, Jinzo, Ningen, Psycho Shocker.
Cyber Energy Shock.
Versago has been vanquished. That's right, Kaiba. You're going to... Even though you're a chosen one, that doesn't mean you can beat me. Go, Ultra Cannon. Fire. Now then, Mystic Tomato. Go, attack. Orenotan. Indo.
Alright, I draw.
Go, Slate Warrior. Go, Slate Warrior. Attack his monster now. Say goodbye to that pathetic tomato. It's annoying me. Not so fast, Kaiba.
Go! Slate Warrior, attack Yugi.
No. I mean, my card has a special ability, don't you know, Kaiba? So now, I get to summon another dark monster to the field. And I think I'll bring forth this one. Go, Witch of the Black Forest, come forth. Go, X-Head Cannon. Cannon Ultra Max.
That's pretty convincing.
That's pretty good.
Alrighty, guys, and we get 134 XP. Yeah. A few other bonuses. We almost time for a new pack.
I lost my money. No! How could you possibly steal it from me, Flood? Well, I don't care.
My name is Marik. I don't care. But if I told you I had such a knowledge of ancient secrets, I don't care. I can still win, even without an Egyptian god card. For I have one of the strongest monsters in existence, the mighty blue-eyes white dragon. Blood, I will get you back for this duel. Remember that.
Destiny has chosen you to carry out my mission. It is my honor to give you the card. What card, Ishizu?
You received the Egyptian god card. Dun, 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 dun,
dun. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Obelisk is ours. And this part is like the best part of the game. The most awesome part. I can't believe this is happening.
Including the card I gave you, there are three different Egyptian god cards. The other one I gave to Yami Yugi.
Three? There are two more?
Yes, they are Slifer the Sky Dragon, Obelisk the Tormentor, and Mega Ultra Chicken.
What was that last one?
I will give Slifer the Dragon to Yugimoto. For as the solver of the Millennium Puzzle, he's also a chosen one. The other card, Mega Ultra Chicken, was stolen. How did it happen, Shizu? I have a favor to ask. Please retrieve the stolen card. My Millennium Necklace has seen the future, and I predict you will say, because shut up. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you. So, guys, let's say you just head to the little deck editing screen here. And how about we pull up the duel disc? It's a pretty important addition. All right. So let's do this. Let's save count now. All right. Now, which deck do I want to try Obelisk in first? I think one of my better decks is... This card is pretty good. Okay. So let's try it in this one, I think. Okay, so we'll take out Witch for Obelisk. Let's take out one of these two. Let's throw in Obelisk. As well as if we see any other good cards, we'll throw them in. Do I have Ancient Lamp? I think I do. There it is. Okay. Going to these. And let's throw in Obelisk, the Tormentor. Torment. I'm tormenting you. Thank you.
Thank you.